something good will happen. Okay. You said that grace is there at all times.
All times. Before you are born, he has kept the milk ready in the mother.
No, that is there, Swamiji, but
is
if something...
Is that grace?
Correct. But if something negative happens to me, how do I associate that with grace?
You are seeing from the individual point of view.
Correct, correct.
And whatever he is doing, it is a universal point of view. So you can never know. It maybe you think that it is pure or this thing, but maybe it is benefit to the entire world.
Okay.
And maybe for the very certain people. See, there is a small child, an innocent child. It is playing in the on the shores of the sea. And Madhvacharya, who is equal to Shankaracharya, he was standing. He didn't do anything. He was just seeing. Suddenly a gale of storm arose. The waves came and took away the child and went away. Again Madhvacharya, he didn't try to go or recover the child. He was just looking at. Somebody told him, "You are a Swamiji. Don't you, at least by words, don't you have any words of sympathy for the child? You didn't do anything, that's a different issue. But at least, don't you have sympathy in your heart on seeing that a small child, an innocent child, being washed off in the ocean?" He said, "When I could see the future, the original future as it was proposed, this boy would have been a pirate. And hundreds of people will die. And thus, this boy had to die in order to save those hundreds." So, individually, it may be called harmful to the boy. But universally, it helped 200 people.
So we cannot associate grace only with positive things happening, what we think is positive.
Yes, yes, correct. Everything is there. Grace, don't think when it comes, it's only for you. The grace of wind is blowing and you just go and take it. And any number of ships can come and take it. So the grace is there. So it is more universal than individual. You may consider whom God has been very graceful. I mean, His grace is there with me and all that. But it's all, she sees from the,
long term.
A very wider point of view.
Swami, I think what she's saying is, suppose I have a child, my child dies, that is also part of grace.
See, why? She was a great devotee, that man. Excellent devotee. But his only fault was, he was deeply attached to that child. See, the Lord has to take him away in order to make him further progress. It is the only thing which is impeding his progress. So it had to be taken away.
So the individual should look at it from that point of view.
That point of view also. So his point of view, human life, with our narrow viewpoint, we cannot think of. We can only, some one or two examples we may give. That's all. But you will never know the extent of His grace. The grace which falls in the entire universe, entire all the galaxies. Something very great.
Even if something negative happens, positive, we are very happy. But if something negative happens, we should think it is for our benefit.
Exactly.
At some time.
You see, Narasimha Swami was a great breeder who had passed out from the bar at London. He was working at Salem as an advocate. It was the day of Shraddham for his father. There on that day, till the Brahmins are fed, nobody else should touch food. He had two children, 6 years old or 5 years old, who were twins. They were asking again and again, मम्मी कुछ दे दो ने, मम्मी कुछ दे दो नहीं, ये समथिंग अर्ली मॉर्निंग कॉन्सेप्ट. मम्मी कुछ दे दो ने, ये बड़ा बनाए मुझे दे दो दो. ये बड़ा तो पहले ब्राह्मण को देने का है, तो नहीं देंगे. सो ये दोनों बच्चों को लेकर शी फिटेड इन द टेरेस, लॉक्ड इन द टेरेस, दे केम डाउन, ऑल द थिंग्स वर डन, द ब्राह्मण वेंट अवे. देन दे वेंट एंड ओपन द डोर एंड कॉल्ड द बॉयज, नन ऑफ देम रिस्पॉन्डेड. They searched everywhere they could find. Finally, they found their bodies floating in the water tank, in the big water tank. That very night, Narasimha Swami left that place. She came to Bhagwan Ramana. And he was the one who wrote the first biography of Ramana called Self-Realization. It's a good one. But he couldn't get his peace of mind here. Then he went further wandering. She went to Shirdi. Nobody had known about Shirdi Baba at that time. She went, she read his dream. He met the people who were with him. He went to the various villages, met those very people. She had that long talk with them all. Then he was so convinced about it. She went from house to house and talked about him. He prepared a lot of lockets and distributed it free. He came to my school in South India village, to Tirumalai. He came there, a short, stout man.
You've seen him?
I've seen him. So he came there and he talked about it, and he was done. Unless the children had died, do you think that such a great man he would have got? After all, the entire thing is an entertainment. It's a dream drama. So in the dream drama also, there is a logic sometimes, or most of the times.
But most of the time, we cannot make out. We don't understand. After so many years, only you have to make out. At that time, you would not have made out anything. That particular
two kinds of temples are now very important.